Hey, apart. I bought this. Okay. A driver, okay. Probably a year ago. Maybe not a year yet, but almost near there. And it was pretty put together. So I decided, since it's getting really old, I'm going to in the jar. I started it already, and then I said, huh, let me show them this little repurposed idea. I think that's it's a pretty jar. It used to have cheese in it. Anyhow, so just to give you an idea of how that looked. Anyway, I'm just popping off the flowers and dropping them in. The prettier ones. Dingy looking ones I'm putting in, but not a lot of them, just to take up space. I think it's neat to just let them fall where they fall. This way they won't make a mess like this huge mess that I have here. Oh goodness. I had it hanging on my dried herbs space on the wall over there. But every time I go over there, I see that some of them are like, you know, similar to that mess here. That's what's happening over there. So anyway, I love flowers. And I really want the ones that are real bright and vibrant colored to pop more. Also, later on this week on one of my days off, I'm going to make some bookmarks with some pressed flowers. That's going to be interesting. We'll see how that turns out. I'm going to do it on a video, of course. Love bookmarks, love books, flowers. You can buy dried flowers online too, but I got these at a craft show. This one's really pretty. Maybe just to stand it in there, break off the stomach a little bit, but just push it down and let it stand up in there. I think that looks good. Have you all tried to do something like this? Let me know. I'll put my email on so you can email me pictures. And if you want to be a part of a YouTube video, I can put your picture on one of my dried flower videos. I just think it's coming along pretty, really pretty. Of course, I'm making a big fat mess.
It's okay. Doing something you love.
Clean the mess later. I do have some dried roses downstairs in the craft room.
I have to go check that out in a little while.
But right now, I think it's coming along pretty.
Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. I love it.
Here's a pretty green one. The original concept I was going for is just the flowers, not the twigs, but
I like the twigs too.
And these are some of my favorite, these purple They're like paper flowers, and even though they're real, it's just the beauty of God's creation. Do it your way, make it your own. That one's gonna be pretty in there. Oh. That this is the way it goes.
Oh, that's so pretty.
Fit a couple more in there. You could also sprinkle some essential oil in here. And then put a net screen, kind of. I don't know. I haven't figured that part out yet, but something on top so you can smell it, and just drip some. Just drip some essential oil down there. Gosh, I lost my words for a second. Isn't that pretty? You could actually put a votive candle in there on top. Let me show you. You have to use these ones that you can bend. That's pretty. And then maybe put a little lace around here. A little lace or burlap. Let me see what I might do.